February is National Heart Month, and sadly, the statistics are quite stark. 1 in 3 Canadian women will die from heart disease, and heart disease is actually the leading cause of premature death for women. So let's find out what we can do in terms of prevention and awareness. Wendy Ray is a nurse clinician. She founded the Women's Healthy Heart Initiative at the MUHC. They're putting on a free event today at 6 o'clock at the hospital. Wendy joins us now. Thanks for your time today, Wendy.
Thanks for having me.
So what compelled you to start this initiative?
We started this initiative in 2009, and I started it because I learned that women were as much at risk of heart disease as men, but that most women don't know that, and that puts them at risk and makes them vulnerable, and I wanted to do something about that.
What's the first thing that you, I guess you just said it. I was going to ask you, what do you think is the first thing you want women to know about heart disease? But that sounds like that's what we need to know, is that it needs to be taken more seriously. It's not something that just affects men.
Absolutely. I think one of the main things is that women are underaware of their risk. It's just not on their radar. So when they're having symptoms, they're not even thinking heart disease. And this is what we need to change, because there's a whole cascade. Women are underaware, therefore they're underdiagnosed, they're undertreated, they're underresearched, and it really starts with awareness, and that's why it's so crucial.
Okay, and so I imagine that's a lot of what you're going to be covering at this event today, but maybe you can tell us some of the symptoms that we should be taking more seriously or paying attention to.
Okay. Things that we should be watching for is specifically a discomfort in our chest, generally across the chest, and it's not necessarily a pain. The woman might describe it more as a burning, a heaviness, a tightness, a pressure, a squeezing that often enough will radiate into the back. One thing that's different between men and women is that women tend to experience other symptoms, other associated symptoms, such as shortness of breath, feeling unwell, feeling sweaty, this kind of thing, which very often men don't. And I know a lot of women tell me, oh, I feel like that pretty well every day,
Yes, off and on.
So sometimes it's hard to decide. But I think the other thing that it's important for women to know, number one, watch for these symptoms and not to triage ourselves. We're very good at that because we tend to be caregivers and nurturers, and we do it all the time. But 100%, you cannot decide at home if you're having a heart attack. You have to go and be checked out.
Okay.
And when you get to the emergency, be sure and tell them why you're there. I'm feeling unwell. I've got a chest discomfort, and I'm afraid I might be having a heart attack. Because a lot of women will say, I don't want to go because I don't want to sit in emergency for 12 hours, et cetera. So if we make it clear why we're there, it will move things along a little bit faster.
I think you're so bang on that as women, we tend to just downplay things and kind of just work through it. And not to say that men don't, it's not a comparison. I can speak to that. I think a lot of women just are like, ah, it's fine. And I don't have the time to go to emergency. You got to take the time, or the absolute worst thing could happen. So tell us, just before we find out about the event happening tonight and how people can participate, I'm curious about how the foundation is funded, because I understand it relies completely on donors.
Yes, unbelievably, because we opened in 2009, Natasha, we are still funded only by private donations. We wouldn't exist. Donations through the MUHC Foundation. We wouldn't exist now if it was not for that. So we're incredibly grateful, because we certainly think this is an important initiative. But prevention is a really tough sell, because results are always down the road, not necessarily today.
So I'll direct people to find out more about the Women's Healthy Heart Foundation at the MUHC Foundation. Initiative, Women's Healthy Heart Initiative, at the MUHC Foundation.com. How can people participate in this free event happening at 6 o'clock tonight?
It's open to the public. It's for everybody, men and women. George Stanisoulis, he's the director of our Cardiovascular Prevention Center, is going to be talking about prevention of heart disease in women. It's not just cholesterol. And I'm going to end it up with a short talk again about signs and symptoms, things that women should be watching for if they think they might be have a cardiac, a heart problem. Other information for today for Wear Red Canada is at wearredcanada.ca, and our website, of course. whhionline.ca. We have a lot of information for women there as well.
Wendy, keep up the great work. I think it's so important what you're doing.
Oh, thank you. Well, thank you for having me, because awareness is so important. And I listen to your show all the time, so I'm sure lots of other people do too. So thank you for having me.
Oh, my goodness. Thank you so much. That is Wendy Ray, nurse clinician and founder of the Women's Healthy Heart Initiative at the MUHC.
Tonight, 6 o'clock, you still have plenty of time.
Exactly.
So pay attention.